Hi, my name is Markus from Microtronics, and I want to show you how to make a simple IoT sensor board using our EasyEDA templates. First, log in into your EasyEDA account, then go to the Microtronics ONE user page on Open Source Hardware Labs. The address is oshwlab.com/microtronics1. Go to Projects. Then open the big template. Click on Editor Open and you'll see the project. First, you have to save a copy of it into your personal space. I rename it with sensor at the end. Then open your personal copy where you can start editing. We want to add the SHD31 temperature and humidity sensor to it. Open the schematics. Then search for the part on the EasyEDA library. Here we go. Put this back. Double click on the part and place it somewhere on the empty space on your schematics. We can leave the reset and alert pin open. It is helpful to place no connect flags. Then we need a ground connection. Just copy that from somewhere else and connect it to EPAD, VSS, ADRED and R. So, copy the ground connection from right here. Oops. What's going on? Connecting wires on your schematics is done by pressing W on your keyboard. Then we want to power it from VCC, the regulator on the template, which is right here, has enough current capacity for additional components. Just copy the symbol of the VCC net and place it beside your sensor. Connect it to VDD. Now you probably need to add a blocking capacitor, copy it from somewhere, for IceCat-C we need some pull-ups. Just copy any resistor on the schematics. This guy is right, fine. It has the right value. We need two of them. Connect the pull-ups to your data lines. Now we only need to connect the data lines to the ONE NRF91. go to docs. docs.microtronics.1, then to hardware overview, then to ONE NRF9160. Scroll down until you get to the default function table. SDA of the interface 0 is on pin 4. SCL of interface 0 is on pin 5. We can just copy the labels, then place them onto the wires. Can rotate the wires, the labels, by pressing space on your keyboard. Let's double check. SDA is on pin 4, SCL is on pin 5. Now the schematics are finished. Don't forget to save by pressing Ctrl S. We can add the new components to the PCB by pressing Design, Update to PCB. First, we want to hide the copper pores by pressing Shift and M on your keyboard. Now place the components on the empty space in the middle. You can rotate them by pressing space on your keyboard. Right here. It's okay. Arrange them. Okay. Route the tracks by pressing W on the keyboard. You can switch the bottom layer by pressing B. Now that all the connections are done, enable the copper pores by pressing Shift and M again. Then rebuild the pores by pressing Shift and B. Maybe there are still some ground connections missing, so I place some wires with V on the keyboard, and then rebuild the copper pores again. Let's see, maybe here. The remaining connections I just connect manually. At the end, I'll check if everything is fine by invoking a DRC check on design, check DRC. There are no messages here, everything is good. You can check the 3D view. Looks good. So if you are now logged into your GLC PCB account, you can order a PCB directly from the EasyEDA tool. Go to order, order PCB. Yes, we've checked here, see, everything is good. Gerber files are processed. At the moment, assembly by GLC PCB is not supported, so be sure to uncheck that. You'll probably need a stencil. Don't forget to order one. Top side only. That's good. If you want to export a bill of materials, we've prepared a configuration that you can download from the documentation page. This is right here. Download. Go to export, bill of materials, import configuration, choose the configuration, export bill of materials. Here you go. For assembling, I recommend the soldering assistance tool from EasyEDA, which is found here. Where you can view the positions of the components for hand assembly. I hope you found that helpful. Be sure to visit the accompanying documentation on docs.microtronics.one. Thank you.